Hello and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today in this tutorial we'll write a Python program to check whether given number is a perfect square or not. An integer that can be expressed as the square of another integer is called a perfect square. For example, 25 is a perfect square because it is 5 square. When I multiply 5 to 5, I'll get 25. 16 is a perfect square because it is 4 square. When I multiply 4 to 4, we'll get 16. Perfect square is the product of same integer with itself. 5 is not a perfect square because I can't write it as square of some integer because it is not the square of some integer. Okay, so now coming to the program, how to write a program to check whether the given number is perfect square or not. For that, I'll use square root method. What I'll do is first I'll find out square root of a given integer number. If the square root is integer, then the given number is perfect square. If it is a float number with some decimal points, then that is not a perfect square number, right? So in the program, first, we'll find the square root of given number. For example, 25 is the given number. First step, what I need to do is I need to find the square root of 25. Okay, to find the square root, I'll use exponent operator. I already made a video on this, how to find the square root of given number. So I'll give you the link of that video in the description box. Okay, here I'll use exponent operator. What I'll do is 25.5. So here in the x, I'll get 5.0. Now what I need to do is I need to convert this input to integer. So output is in the float form. I need to convert that to integer. So I need to take int of x. Then I'll get 5, right? Integer form. So now 5 is a perfect integer, right? And 5 multiply 5, I'll get 25. So that is the given number. So that means 25 is the perfect square. Another example, given number is 5. I need to check whether 5 is a perfect square or not. What I'll do is first I'll find the square root of 5. So 5 exponent 0.5. Okay, so I'll get a number here, 2.233 something. Next step is I need to convert it to integer. And next I need to multiply that with itself, that is int a multiply int a, like this. I'll get 4. 4 is not equal to 5, that is the given number. So 5 is not a perfect square. Here we are using this method to find whether the given number is perfect square or not. So let's write the program. First step is we need to take the input from the user. Here input is an integer number. Just take a variable, use input function, write a message, and here we need integer input, but in Python 3 by default this input function will take input as string value, but here we want integer input. That's why I'll use int function to convert that string input to integer. Done with the first step. Next step is now we have number, right? We need to check whether that number is a perfect square or not. So for that, first, we need to find the square root of that number. Just take a variable, any variable, and I'll use exponent operator num, that is the given number, exponent operator 0.5. Okay, now here we'll get a result. That result will be in the float form, but here we want integer number. That's why I'll convert that output to integer using int function. Next. Now, if I multiply x, that is the square root of given number, with itself, if I get the given number, then that is the perfect square. If you get different number, then the given number is not a perfect square. So for that, I'll use if condition and I'll multiply x with x. If it is equal to given number, num, then print a message. Else, it is not a perfect square. Okay, this is the message. First, take the input, that is integer number, find out square root and convert that to integer. Then if I multiply that square root of number with itself, I need to get the given number. If not, that is not a perfect square. Okay, let's save this and execute this. Let's take 5. 5 is not a perfect square. Let's take 25. 25 is a perfect square of 5. When I multiply 5 with itself, I'll get 25. And if I take 100, 100 is perfect square of 10. If I multiply 10 with 10, I'll get 100. Okay, so this is about this program. So that's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.